Hi, I'm Lovely, and today I'm going to review Torchwood Among Us Episode 3, Misty Eyes. Let's just get into thoughts and predictions already, since I haven't listened to this episode. I am excited. Let's start by reading the description. So, Misty Eyes by Tim Foley. Tim Foley's doing this. Ooh, I see Tim Foley's doing this one, and James Goss is doing the next one. Okay, these are okay. So, Misty Eyes. Gwen Cooper and Reese Williams have made a new life for themselves in Iceland, away from death and aliens and the horror in Torchwood. Until there's a knock on the door from the last person they want to see. Okay. I don't think it's anyone we know, the person that's going to be knocking. If I had to guess. Interesting. Kind of interesting that we don't start off with Gwen and Reese. Considering that's a big thing, them both coming back to the series. Okay. So I said it before, the only thing I'm worried about when it comes to this episode is that I want them to acknowledge that Gwen and Reese have another child. They have a son now. Iceland. Okay, this is interesting. I think the series is going to be really, really good. I think it's a lot of just... I enjoy the Monster of the Week format a lot more in Big Finish's series compared to, like, let's say, Series 1 and 2 of the show. I really like it. There's something just chill about it. I'm hoping this episode is a bit more engaging than the last two, but I don't think I'll complain. I won't mind this. Do I think we're going to figure out who the bad guys are? No. they take their time. they take their time. We usually won't find out until the end, and then that's, I'm gonna be real, that's an if. For example, we don't find out, like, what happened, or, like, it's not revealed yet to everybody with Gwen in Aliens Among Us that she's been, like, taken or replaced or whatever word, you know what I mean. We don't really, that doesn't conclude until the end. Like, we're gonna be building this up for a little bit. I'm really excited. I think I just want to get into it. A Tim Foley script. I'm excited. Yeah, I'll see you in a bit. Hi, I'm Lovely, and I just got finished listening to Misty Eyes by Tim Foley. And, that was probably one of the better, if not, like, one of the best Torchwood stories. It was really, really good. Where do I even start? So, one, to acknowledge it, because I said it in the other reviews and the beginning of this one. One, this was recorded, what was it, like, 4 years ago? It was recorded a while ago, 2019, 2020. And I want to say this now, so I won't bring it up more in the future. I believe this takes place before Gwen and Reese have another, before they have their son. And that is fine. I just want to acknowledge that, because I knew I was going to be bothered if it didn't make any sense. It makes sense. And even if it didn't, I think I'll be fine now. I won't be hung up on it. But no, this was really, really good. I feel so bad for them that they had to hold on to the story privately for so long. Oh my god, that must have sucked. I have that with, like, the little projects I've worked on, that kind of thing. And again, those are super, super little. And this Torchwood is such a big thing, and they've had this story just sitting there, like, waiting, kind of, for years. Insane. It was really good. Gwen was fantastic. Gwen, Reese, Aang, oh my god, it was all good. I assume this story takes place before the first one, before Aliens Next Door. Because I believe it was, like, again, this one was, I believe, written and... I'm not going to say produced all the way, but they said Eve recorded her lines in 2019, and I think everyone else did in 2020. I could be wrong. Sorry if I am, but I believe this takes place before the first one. But it doesn't have to, if that makes sense. But no, this was such a good energy. This was a really good energy. I really like what they did with Gwen, and I don't know if she's going to be in it more, but she doesn't really need to. They set it up in a way where she's like, yeah, Torchwood needs money. I got them. I'll always be Torchwood. And I think that's really good. I like this addition to her ending. Presumed ending. I'm a big fan. God, no, so good. All the character with Aang Oh my god. That was rough. That was really rough, but it was cool getting to learn all this stuff. I don't remember a lot of it right now, but it's really good to have that for the character and just for the universe in the show. It's a lot of lore building, and that's one of my favorite things with Torchwood, how much lore there is, especially with the audio dramas. I haven't checked out the comics or like the radio stories they did beforehand, before Big Finish, all that kind of stuff, but the lore for Torchwood is wild. But no, it was really good. I didn't even think about the title Misty Eyes until they said it. It didn't click for me. The mist was a good enemy. It was very scary. It was generally like, well, I don't know how we solved this. I was on the edge of my seat. It was really good. Tim Foley is fantastic. I need to look at what other stories he did, because I know I recognize the name. He's everywhere. But God, that was really good. What a good way to bring Gwen back, even if it's for a single episode. It was really, really good. God, and Reese is always so fun. Reese, I feel like, look, Reese had to deal with a lot in those first two seasons of Torchwood, especially when it came to Gwen. And he's so good. The actor is also fantastic. I love everything about it. Whenever you listen to the interviews for like any of it, they really goof around. It's really funny. You can tell that the energy is there. It's super funny. God, what a good episode. That one is very, it's my favorite one so far from the season. The next one is, I believe, a Tyler episode. I don't have much else to say, other than I really like this episode. I can't wait to see what comes in the future. I'm really excited. This has been a really good season so far. I'm Lovely. Thank you for watching.